You're watching News Leader 9 with Cheryl Renee and meteorologist Greg Majeski.
American tourists are finally leaving Mexico after being caught in the middle of Hurricane Odile. Flights out of Los Cabos have been hard to come by. The storm caused severe damage to the airport. The Mexican military had to be brought in to help organize evacuation efforts.
That's going to take a while to get the recovery going down there. It was a lot of shelters are running out of food and supplies, but they're starting to get help in there now. So
good news there.
Of course, all that rain now has moved into Texas from Odile, causing a lot of
flooding.
It caused
severe
the flooding out there. But we're not expecting any of that moisture to come this way. That's the good news here. So let's go ahead and take a look what's trending with that forecast. And remember, as always, you can follow us on Facebook and on Twitter. Definitely dealing with the lower humidity all across the Chattahoochee Valley for today. Temperatures will be trending downward over the next 7 days. And we're looking at the rain chances to be pretty much on the slim side. There's some isolated chances here and there. I'll show you on the 7 day, but nothing that's going to be too widespread. Let's take a look right now at the 999 Radar Network. All clear again once again for this afternoon. No rain expected across the area for today. And temperatures quite pleasant. They've been warmer to the south because we're getting more sunshine down here. 82 degrees in Eufaula, but we've been stuck in the clouds. Roanoke's stuck at 70 degrees right now. 75 in LaGrange, 78 degrees here in Columbus. What we're seeing right now is just a thin layer of some clouds right through portions of the state right there. Got sunshine in North Georgia and to the south, and a little thin layer right across the central areas. Here's all the leftover moisture from Odile that we were talking about. It's dropping some pretty heavy rains there south of Amarillo and looking at some rains back over toward Houston. This area has been infected by, you know, impacted by drought conditions, so they could definitely use the rain. Just hopefully they won't get a lot of flooding in this. But our weather here close at home is looking pretty good. Again, there's that closer view there of the thin layer of clouds there. So if you're driving up I-185, may run into the clouds and then break into the sunshine again once you head up toward the ATL, up toward Atlanta. So not looking bad for this afternoon. Now, future casts, I go ahead and put this into motion for you. Again, nothing in the way of precipitation expected for this afternoon. Tomorrow, we're going to get a little more of an easterly flow. Might see a few scattered showers around for tomorrow evening. I don't think it'll be a big impact for the high school football games, but should be few and far between. But as we go into Saturday into Sunday, again, Saturday looking pretty good across our region, and so is Sunday. So both Saturday and Sunday looking good for any weekend plans for the last wrap up for summer as we head toward the fall. Looking at your forecast for this afternoon, let's go ahead and break it down up here toward the north. We're starting with LaGrange at 87, Lafayette at 86, and this will be dependent on if we break that sunshine. It may inhibit these temperatures by a few degrees. Kind of hard to nail that down when you're dealing with such a thin layer of clouds. Now, further south, it should be a little warmer. Fort Benning, 89, Columbus, 88 degrees, Auburn at 87, 86 in Ellaville. And for our southern zones, a little warmer here. Eufaula will probably get close to 90, Cuthbert at 88, and 87 degrees in Dawson. Take a look for your high school football action for tonight. Big game going on tonight between Troop and Carver. Kickoff temperature about 85 degrees, 78 degrees as the whistle goes and blows out. Should be a good game for tonight. Good weather for it as well. And the rest of the 7 day forecast looking very good indeed. There's that slight chance of rain for tomorrow. Again, not a big deal, just a very spotty chance of an isolated shower or two. And the weekend looking great with temperatures in the mid 80s, overnight lows in the mid 60s. Of course, fall kicks in at 10:29 p.m. on Monday.
And then
we're going to come in maybe some slightly cooler temperatures for the middle of next week.
Oh, something to look forward to.
Looking great.
Finally. All right. Thanks so much, Greg. Well, the House gives.